Now, last week, Arthur said this comedian has blossomed into a beautiful, gentle dancer. Well, he never thought he'd be adding that to his CV. Dancing the salsa is Kevin McGahern and Laura Nolan.
Congratulations to both of you working in harmony together with the movement across the floor, because overall, I think you captured the sentiment of Foxtrot absolutely perfectly. Well done.
Next week, it's fun. It's a lot of hip. We're doing salsa.
Ooh, spicy.
This is where the funk begins. We're bringing the disco. Salsa is all about your hips. We have a lot of lifts and a lot of tricks. Not bad at all. It's a fast tempo, so there's no room for error.
No room for thinking in this. You just have to move. I'm quite nervous with the lifts. You know, you can do it when you're sort of psyching yourself up and you've got 5 seconds to prepare. But in the dance, you have no time. You're just like, bang, lift, up, down. What's happening now?
A one, a two. I'm a little bit worried about Sunday. Kevin is having issues remembering the transitions from step to step. Back and funk it out.
Oh, yeah.
My brain just cannot keep up with the dance. It's not a case of, like, make it easier. We can't. It's quarterfinals. We need to kick it up a gear.
I have faith in Kevin that he'll get this, and I know come Sunday night, this will be one of his best dances yet.
Dancing the salsa, Kevin McGahern and Laura Nolan.
You made those lifts look seamless. Were you nervous doing them on the floor tonight?
Kind of, yeah. The last thing you want to do is drop a woman on her head.
No, you don't want to do that on
live television.
You don't want to do that. And that little ass shake you did was phenomenal.
Spot on.
Phenomenal.
Thank you very much.
Arthur.
Kevin, you have come a long way from your Venice Waltz from week one to salsa in quarter final.
Yeah.
You know? I feel like your personality really meshed so well with the salsa. And then I saw you moving your hips. I mean, who knew you had that?
Oh.
I love it. I noticed, Arthur.
Those lifts are not easy to execute, but you did it. You absolutely did it, and it was effortless for you. You actually made it happen. And you know what? For me, that salsa had every ingredient to be spicy.
Ooh, spicy. Okay, we'll go to Brian now.
Well, it was a perfectly traditional salsa, creating perfect summer vibes. There's absolutely no doubt about it. You accomplished most of that well, particularly the lifts, as you said, a big, big challenge in that regard. Laura, as a dancer, is packed full of energy. She wants to challenge you. She wants to push that on. And there's no doubt tonight that she absolutely loaded the challenges into the choreography for you. But that's a sign that she believes you, and you should take some credit for that as well. There was a couple of moments that weren't great. Some of the salsa basics were a bit stompy, and the pot stirrer down here, that was a bit stodgy. But, I mean, it's about the quarterfinal. It's time we need to up those challenges. And Laura is definitely asking you to do that. I think, overall, you dealt with most of those challenges quite well tonight.
Mm-hmm. OK. Not bad. Not bad, Lorraine.
Salsa needs, it needs partnering skills, and I think you both had this tonight. The one action that you had a lot of was turns, and lots of turns. And it was all done with the arms, and it got really, really tricky as well. But you really did do that very well. But at the same time, you kept that rhythm going. And there, those hips really then could come out, and it was very, very clear. Now, I want to give you a little tip. Okay, you're going to get your weight onto the balls of those feet. No, no, your full weight, all the feet, and get a more dominant position. It's too much in the heels, so you're not quite getting involved. Stakes are high. That means you had to do risky lifts, and I feel it paid off tonight. So well done to you both.
Lorraine said it paid off. She said it paid off. Kevin and Laura!
Quarterfinals, it's time to up the challenges, and you did that with those lifts.
Yes, they were tough.
They really were. I gave them really hard lifts.
Yeah, I definitely think this was definitely the toughest week for
was
me.
Was it?
Yeah, I was on the verge of a breakdown. I was going to the garage, Jern.
Well, Arthur mentioned you've come a long way from the Viennese Waltz. Does that feel like a distant memory?
Yeah, how long was that? Like, I didn't realise it was March.
It's March.
Somebody told me it was March
it's
today.
It's March, Kevin.
That's
Mother
crazy.
Say it soon.
That is
Get
crazy.
With the program. Yeah. Tell me, did Kevin drop you much in training, Laura?
There was a lot of bumps and bruises, and but you have to go through that to get to a good lift.
Yes.
It's just part of the process. And at times he was like, "Oh God, I don't want to do it. Like, can we change it?" But look, he managed to do everything and
Absolutely.
Nailed it. So that's what it's all about.
Arthur mentioned the spiciness of it all. The hips were. Looking fantastic.
You. Darren, you're embarrassing me.
You said it could be his best dance yet. Laura, do you still feel that?
I absolutely do think that it was. Yeah, it was really, really good. I think I really challenged him with a lot of the arms and stuff.
Yeah.
I didn't go easy and just give him, like, loads of basics and that.
Yes.
And it was a fast tempo, so he definitely delivered.
She throws a lot at me.
Yeah.
She does.
Well, in the mix as well, you were gigging during the week.
Yeah, I was supporting Joanna McNally in Vicar Street on Tuesday night.
I didn't know she's doing Vicar Street.
Apparently so. I think she's ready to buy it at this stage. They're going to rename it the Joanna McNally Theatre.
The scores are in.
The judges have their scores. Brian Redman.
7.
Lorraine Barry.
8.
Arthur Gullendiak.
8.
That is a total of 23, but your opinion at home is just as important. When we open the voting lines later in the show, you can vote for Kevin and Laura by calling 1513 71 7104 or texting Kevin to 53125. Give it up for Kevin and Laura.
Coming up in a couple of minutes, Carl's got bills he has to pay, and he's not the only one, so here's a commercial break. But first, your chance to win a 5-star shopping break right here in Dublin.